the 70s. So it's nice to be in Delhi. In Mumbai, we are better known. Sai Estate Consultants in the city of Mumbai is seen on the hoardings, in print. I'm going to talk a little bit about Sai Estate Consultants because this is a new market and I'm delighted to have a new office in CP in Delhi. So I would want to also tell you how Sai Estate Consultants can add value to each one of you in this this area that we have all gathered at. So Sai Estate Consultants started in the year 2010 and it was started by me. I had 6 years of XPT coffee, wherein non-vegetarian, to one alpha, Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, and 60 alpha, a client who wanted only non-vegetarian and would not settle for, unless I gave him a piece of chicken or something to do with non-vegetarian. So that's where I learned the art of customer service. And somewhere, I'm happy that I dropped out of college to join such a premier airline that taught me when you sell a 15-20 rupee coffee, the consumer wants everything. The guest wants everything. And when my 200 sales guys today come back and tell me that, sir, the guy says, I am ready to buy a flat, but I will not pay 2 lakh rupees for a car park. By the way, in Maharashtra, Gaya, we can sell car park as far as it is designated. So we charge specifically for a car park. So, we tell our sales guys also that I have sold tea coffee at 15 rupees and yet delivered the cup, landed right on the spot with a smile on my face, managed to look good, managed to feed Bombay Baroda passengers, 182 passengers, feed them, give them tea coffee, take the trays back. By the time they're not even eating yet. The reason I'm telling you all this is because today the entire real estate industry revolves around one important factor, which is called consumer sentiments. So you can have the best product. In Mumbai, we have Lodas doing skyscrapers and looking at huge apartments, great value, amazing locations, too much work with them because now I'm in the affordable housing. But the point is they are great communicators. They use the media in a way, they are creating a niche for themselves. So at this point in time, I think consumer sentiments is the most important amenity that a consumer is looking at. If I cut out a check worth 5 lakh rupees, I am actually not wondering whether you are going to give me Italian marble or you are going to give me normal kadappa tile. That comes secondly. I first want to know that a check will be able to build a house. Isn't it? That is the, the big question mark. At Sai Estate Consultants, we take 6,000 phone calls every day. So anybody who believes that markets are sluggish and it is difficult to sell inventory, in MMR, we close minimum 100 crores deals every week. And our weekend starts on a Tuesday afternoon at 2:30. The only downtime we have is on Monday because the response is amazing. I can tell you that what we do is not a CSR activity, but there is great job satisfaction doing what we do because we work with developers who offer a 30% discount. And I understand that developers are in pain and there is no money in the system, that developers are facing losses, they are also paying interest. But once you are stuck, you have to come out of the rut. And the best way to come out and maintain liquidity is to say, okay, this is my price, this is the inventory, I'm not making any money. I made money for the last 20 years. You try and ask an NRI what the NRI thinks about the Indian development industry. And the standards that we have, it will not be a very pleasant thing to give you a very honest feedback. Considering that you have a new office in Marina Bay in Dubai, we get a lot of feedback, which is absolute in contrast to what our Indian consumers say. So the point I'm trying to make here is that this is a time where we have to all, as a fraternity, brokers, bankers, developers, I do not have the ability to tell you that I have no bad intention. I will follow Gaga, I will give you amazing product line, but I do not really convince the consumer there is no point in going in that direction. And I've been warned by of course KPMG is also one of our knowledge partners. We also work with EY and we also work with good ad agencies. I am 33, but I deal with people who have 33 years and plus of experience. So I like to go with them. My CMO, CEO are all much older than what I am. But I take their word and they all warn me that यार आप NCR जा रहे हो, वहाँ पे तो बहुत सप्लाई है, वहाँ पे तो बहुत अनसोल्ड स्टॉक है, तो बी केयरफुल बिकॉज लॉट ऑफ मनी है, लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव लॉस्ट मनी एंड देयर नॉट बीइंग एबल टू डू अ गुड जॉब. आई एंटर द मार्केट इन 2010 एंड 2014 टाइम्स वर नॉट ऑल दैट गुड, बट इन सर्टेन पॉकेट्स वी हैड एप्रिसिएशन एज फार एज इन्वेस्टर सेंटीमेंट्स आर कंसर्न. बट 2014 इट्स बीन अ टफ टास्क, बट इट्स अ वेरी वेरी एक्साइटिंग वन. One experience I would want to share with you. After 2014, we stopped communicating with all individual retail investors because they'll say, I believe that there is no capital appreciation in Mumbai markets after 2014. And if I tell an investor, sir, ki 10,000 rupees mein le lo, aur main 14,000 rupees mein aapko 2015 mein bech ke deta hu, to aaj main yahan nahi khada hota tha. My phone would have been filled with messages and WhatsApp messages. Saying that sir, आपने exit नहीं दिया मुझे. This is the reality. Today, people who have assets worth 500 crores have problem sending 5-10 lakh rupees of RTGS. That's the ground reality because the liquid position has been that way. People, I won't talk about GST, RERA and demonetization because these are three things that, being an optimist, as per my study, eventually will all phase out. And this is for the betterment of the country and to make Indian real estate to be perceived in a way which is not something, you know, that will keep us down when we have a discussion in the United States talking about Indian real estate and Indian developers. So on this note, I am always my 200 member team and now we are recruiting 15 to 20 people every weekend. And I must tell you certain facts about Sai Estate Consultants. We buy media worth 90 crore rupees every fiscal year. ATL, BTL, Outdoor, from Times of India, Hindustan Times, Midday and various other places. And we have chosen to be as aggressive, inversely proportional to the market. So as the market keeps going back, we keep pushing harder. If there are four brokerage houses that have gone down because they have not really put that extra effort, there was a time in 2016 I used to work 14 hours. Now I've gone to 18 and a half, 19 another day. Because this is the time. I believe this is the opportunity because there has been an organic correction in the market as far as consumers are concerned. Only if the entire development fraternity accepts that haan mujhe thoda loss ho gaya hai, is there a way I can come out of this situation? Let me not go to a bank and borrow at 27-28%. Rather give that 28-30% collected discount to the consumers and they'll be delighted to deal with me. With such ideologies, we managed to sell multiple units in Mumbai. And though I am very comfortable conducting business in MMR, because we have 1,50,000 crore of unsold stock in MMR, and at my company's end, we do only 5,500 crores every year. Even if I double my capacity, I will not be able to do more than 10,000 crores every fiscal year. So I have 1,40,000 crore of ocean there for me to conquer. But I felt that the concept of 30-40-30, which Sai Estate follows, where initially we tell the developer to give us a 30% discount and then there is immediate subscription because we attract, we buy a lot of media, talk about it, whether it is digital, whether it is NRI, whether it is exhibitions. After the name is created of that specifically, I tell you, one of the problems of most of the developers here, they have some great legacy, but I don't know why they have a mind block towards advertising and marketing. So when it comes to having a jacket on the front page, they feel that, you know, this is my experience. Most of the developers feel, yeah, mujhe ad karne ki zarurat nahi hai, mere paas to khali 500 crore rupees ka maal hai, why do I advertise? So you know, these are things that keep me in business because we take up such projects and take the entire advertising marketing and believe you me, we are a debt free organization. I have said no to a couple of private equities who have come to me in Mumbai for my 18-20% shares, but you have chosen to remain debt free because when I sign my check, I want to take my own decisions and not basis an investor or a bank or a private equity who dictates terms. This is my understanding on the subject. We are looking at an IPO by 2019-20, which will be India's first IPO that comes from a brokerage house which is less than 10 years old and is not backed up by any big daddy sending me US dollars, or nor my daddy has left anything back for me to really take off from. So, as you guys must have guessed it by now, I'm an absolute optimist and we have taken MMR by storm. We are known for positive disruption and we will continue to add as much value as possible, continue to ensure that we meet our goal, which is one home for every Mumbai. Now that I'm speaking in Delhi, I take the privilege to call it one home for every Indian. I thank each one of you for giving me this opportunity to be here. Thank you, Thought Bubbles, who've been our ad agency. Thank you, Alchemist, who's traveling with us. Thank you, our PR agency, White Mark, and all my 208 lovely boys and girls between 25 to 65 years who ensure that we do an amazing job every single day, 18 and a half, 19 hours.